Hi, my name is Ivan Musto and welcome from here Siem Reap, Cambodia, one of the most popular tourist destinations in Asia and especially Cambodia. And today I want to share you guys my story where I was almost camped and I wasted a lot of time, a lot of energy with my close friend just yesterday that I arrived to Siem Reap. We had a long journey from Phnom Penh to Po Sat. We stayed in Po Sat a couple of days. Then we had a 7-hour bus journey to Siem Reap. And of course, it was the new year for Cambodian people. That's why we booked a hotel online. We used agoda.com and we booked for 2 nights. A nice hotel which seemed to be good looking, with a swimming pool, with breakfast included. Everything seemed to be perfect until we reached there and we were shocked, because once we reached there we spoke to the manager and the manager said that, wow, you don't have any room booked. And we were shocked, we were angry, because my friend had used his debit card to issue the payment, and we had already done it. We already did it, and we supposed to go there and have fun and relax after our long journey. But in the end, we were really disappointed, because once we got there, the manager just said that you have to pay extra money. You have to pay me this amount if you want to stay here. And for me, I was very tired. I thought that, okay, we should just go back to find another place. I mean, it's okay, just $50. But my friend, my Cambodian friend, persisted. And we stayed there for 4 hours. And we called the Agoda. And they checked that we had done the reservation already. Everything was there already. Everything was already done. But the funny thing that the manager, the Cambodian manager of this hotel, he keeps saying that we had made no booking at all. And we were angry. But after we called the hotline number in the UK, which redirected us to the number in Hong Kong, we discovered that the booking was made. Everything was going well until that happened, that the manager came to us and said, hey, show me your booking ID number, because the Agoda had called the owner of the hotel, and the owner of the hotel called the manager. And when the manager finally discovered that this thing just became more serious, that one of the things that you need to make sure when you make a booking is always take a screenshot or write down the booking ID, your ID number, because when you register in an app you will have your own ID number, and also the last 4 digits of your debit card, because it's very important. Once there is a problem like that the manager will try to say that you have not made the booking, or the cash, the money was not paid to them. Once you have the reference number, the booking number, the ID number, and also the last four digits of your debit card or credit card, you will have proof that you have made that reservation. So no one can cheat you. In fact, we were lucky that that agoda.com refund us with the full amount and even gave us extra cash of 10% of our original payment, which can be used in the 6 months time frame. So that's why I encourage you guys to be very careful, because you can get scammed. You can get scammed, and you have to be very careful. You have to watch out. You have to have all documents that prove your booking, because this might have happened in Siem Reap, but it can happen anywhere around the world. So be very careful. Then he asked for our ID number, for our booking number. So I just want to tell you guys that be careful, because some managers, they don't want to say to their owners. They don't want to, they just, you know, there is the booking is made, and some people, they come to the hotel, and the manager might say, oh, there is an error with the system. We don't have any booking. What are you talking about? There is nothing that was done. And you might like just say, okay, let it go. It's just $20, $50, doesn't matter. But the manager was trying to cheat us, rip us off, because he knew that most people that would come to the hotel would do such thing. You know, they would just let it go. It's just $50, just $20. It's okay. So be aware of this. Be aware of this. Before you make a booking, you should call the property and make sure that the booking was made. And don't believe what the manager might say, because they might lie to you. They might say a fairy tale to you so that they can use that room that you book to let other people keep it or book it. So be very careful of this. Be very careful. We were almost scammed last night. And even when I ordered some food, and I had the loklak, I had fried rice, and the total bill was $7.50. I gave 50,000 riel, which is about $12.50, to the manager, and he returned to me only $3 instead of $5. And when I tried to talk to him, like, what the hell, what happened? Why are you giving me just $3? Why not $5? He said, oh, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. Oh, I thought you gave me only 10. So be aware. Some hotel managers, they might lie to you that their system is broken, that some malfunction, that the booking was not done at all. So be very careful. Be very careful. This is a scam. So if you want to avoid being scammed, I suggest you to always believe on the app, because it's always an agreement between the owner of the property and the Agoda or booking.com or any other traveling booking site. So this is my experience. I hope you guys can take something from it. Be careful. Siem Reap is a wonderful destination for all people, but be very careful, because you can get scammed. And this is not just for Siem Reap. Anywhere, if there is a booking and the booking was done online, double check to make sure that everything is okay. And if it was done online, the payment was already made, don't believe if they tell you that the booking was not made. And don't believe them if they say that payment was not made, if the company, the booking app, already deducted money from your bank account. So I hope you guys enjoyed my video. If you like the video, please like, share it to your friends, and subscribe to my blog, to my YouTube channel. And from here, Siem Reap, Cambodia, I see you guys next time. Cheers.